most healthy functioning communities, it is the community that takes responsibility. They take responsibility for the crime. They take responsibility for parents. They take responsibility for the miseducation of a system because no one parent, and let's keep in mind, put this in context, 75% of all black kids are raised by single parent mothers, and a significant portion of those mothers are poor. So to ask a single parent poor mother to bear the brunt of the responsibility of effectively looking out for their child, I think that's a bit too much responsibility with the lack of accountability on the community itself. It should be the community. Where are the churches at in this? Where are the community-based organizations at this? Where are the black businesses in this? Where are the fraternities and the sororities in this? Where are the black conscious communities in this? We have too many stakeholders to claim to be about the business of our people. We have too many people collecting money on Sunday for us to always turn around and look at the parent. I do not blame the parents alone. Yes, they must be held accountable, but I also understand that they are operating within a community that is dysfunctional and that does not in any way, shape, or form support our black parents. So when I look at the graduation rates, when I look at special ed rates, when I look at the ADHD rates, when I look at the mental retardation rates, when I look at the juvenile incarceration rates, when I look at the dropout rates, I'm not saying our parents are horrible. I'm saying our communities are horrible.
Well, Dr. Johnson, I can kind of see where you're coming from with that, but it sounds like you are taking the responsibility away from home, and home is where it starts.
The community is where it starts, not the home.
The home is where it starts. You know, I'm a mother, and I believe that it is the mother's duty or the parental duty to be directly involved in your child's life and development, and I don't hold my community accountable for that. That is up to me. Now, it's great to have community support, but at the end of the day, the community is made up of other moms and fathers. That's exactly what it's made up of. Everyone doesn't need to utilize churches or outreach centers and things like that in order to get that. And right, the question that CW posed was really just how does the parent actually play into getting more involvement or, you know, helping with the system the way it is set up now as far as diagnosing these babies. You haven't given us a way to do that yet. You're just taking the blame off of the parent and putting it onto the community, and it's not the community's fault at the end of the day. At the end of the day, it's up to the parent to raise those children. It's great to have that, and yes, we do say it does take a village, and we do need that, but to say that it does not, you know, that you don't hold the parent accountable, to me, is reckless and irresponsible.
Okay. Well, firstly, I don't think you listened to what I said, because I was very clear in stating that parents do bear a degree of responsibility. But I am going to have to significantly disagree with you. My perspective is rooted in African culture. And in African culture, the parents are not the first line. It's the community. In African culture, the elders and the community determine even how families are constructed. The community even determines how the families are constructed. They even determine who can get married. So for me, I totally disagree with the individualistic approach. That is a European narrative. I cannot endorse that at all. I'm going to maintain my position that it is the community that has to unite and create the opportunities for our children. There's no way on earth I'm going to blame single black mothers for what's going on with our children when so many of them are doing the best that they can to raise them on their own. No way I'm going to do that. I just got an email the other day in Washington, D.C. A message went out that the government of the District of Columbia is going to be cutting off over 15,000 single black mothers off of public assistance, which is aid to families with dependent children. What are those mothers going to do? Am I still going to turn around and tell them that it's your fault that your child is underachieving in school when now she probably has to work an additional job to keep the lights on because there is no community infrastructure to take some of the responsibility off of her shoulders so that she don't have to struggle as much? I mean, you're talking about a black community, by the way, that spends $600 million on McDonald's every year, that spends $9 billion on perm and weave every year, that spends $4 billion on alcohol every year. We have enough money coming into our community that our children should all be attending independent African schools. The conversation about special ed should shouldn't even exist for black people. The conversation about ADHD shouldn't even exist for black people. The conversation about Ritalin and Adderall and Concerta and Vyvanse and Cycler and Zoloft, it shouldn't even exist for us, because we live in a community that could take its Christmas money and give black children an independent education. So what makes this so sad is that we even have to have the conversation, because we come from a people who have the financial wherewithal to create a new reality for their children. I will not blame the single mother.
Okay, well, the single mother is not about blaming the single mother. That's not the point of the conversation. Every person or every child with special needs does not come from a broken home. We're talking about the special needs and the system of the children. That's what the question was targeted to. It wasn't about weaves and perms and about Christmas money. It wasn't about that necessarily. It was just saying, you know, hey, how do we, you know, as a people, because you said that the parent is not, or the mother is not accountable, the parent is not accountable. I'm just saying that that's one demographic of the African-American community. That's one different demographic of it. But everyone in the African-American community who still might go through these issues do not fall into that category.
Okay.
Can you hear, Doctor?
You're breaking up a little. I can hear you clearly. She doesn't sound as clearly as you sound right now. I don't know if her mic is... You sound crystal clear. She sounds a little faded out towards the latter part of her comment.
Come on, keep talking. Let me, you know what? Now, I love the passion that each one of you are bringing to this, and this is important in regards to dialogue, because you get to see each individual, understand each individual. And I kind of understand where you're coming from, sir, in regards to the dynamic. And it's kind of ironic, because when you mentioned it as far as the, you know, how communities were back in African times in regards to how, of course, the elders dictated as far as, you know, how we were to interject with each other, how we were to marry and such. So let's fast forward then to, of course, you know, we're currently here, 2017, 21st century, and basically, as you mentioned, we have single mothers that are raising kids. We have situations in which fathers aren't stepping up to bat in order to do what they need to do. So, of course, you have those broken homes. Then you have blended families. And not to mention, you know, even, you know, several of your colleagues have even mentioned, you know, a lot of times when these children are being diagnosed, you know, some of the outlying factors are, you know, some sort of trauma at home, you know. So, again, it kind of reflects back to my question as far as the family unit or how it begins at home. Because let me just share a little something with you. I have a mother and father that are still together after 50 years, and that's a blessing, okay? My mother and father graduated with a 6th and 8th grade education, okay? And from that, I was able to, of course, do what I had to do in school. I was hyper, you know? My parents didn't want me to be on Ritalin. They refused it. They let me do what I need to do, and I advanced in my classes. I was actually, when I lived in New York, I was ahead of kids that were in first grade. I was going to second and third grade, okay? I put myself through college. I obtained 2 degrees, all those things, and I've raised 3 sons that, in turn, are doing the same thing. So, again, I'm questioning that, how it's not part of the family to be responsible for the upbringing of the child. If anything, I would think that it's my job to prepare my sons and teach them, so therefore they're not a hindrance or fall into the system or go against the community. Would that be safe to say?
Okay, I don't think you heard me either, my brother.
No, I heard
never
you.
Said
I heard
parents were not
I,
responsible.
I did hear you. I'm
I said
asking.
The community is more responsible, is what I'm saying. Okay, the fact that you did a good, first of all, your analysis is rooted in your own individual experience. And see, that's one of the problems that we have as black people. We take our own individual narrative and try to treat it as if it was capable for everybody. I cannot sit here as Dr. Umar Johnson with 6 degrees, okay, with a doctorate, being only 1% of all Americans with a PhD, okay, having never been to jail, I cannot take my narrative and say that this was possible for every black male, because I know it is not. I know when I went through school, I was selected to be in certain programs because my father was there. You just mentioned your parents were married. You benefited from that. That was a privilege you had that other black males did not have. And the only way we can guarantee that they would have ended up like you is if the community would have organized to make sure that there was a safety net for the other black boys, so they could have all done as good of a job as you have as a father raising your three sons. We have to get out of the European narrative of looking at everything from an individualistic responsibility perspective. Sociology. I'm a psychology major. Sociology deals with group behavior. Mm-hmm. And one of the first things you learn in the study of sociology is whenever the group works together, a lot of the individual problems that members in that group suffer from will be alleviated. Look at the European Jewish community. Look at the Chinese community. Look at the Arab, the East Indian. Look at the Italian community. They work as a group. It doesn't mean they don't have delinquency. It doesn't mean they don't have some issues. But they're able to safeguard against a lot of the things that black people have, because so much of our perspective is rooted in an individual narrative.